Following the Monday roundtable engagement with the police at its headquarters in Nagru, the National Unit Platform leadership agreed to readjust their mobilization drive to suit the new police guidelines. On Wednesday morning, June 29th, NUP President Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu convened his team at the party offices in Kavuli and briefed them ahead of the Mukono trail, appealing for discipline and asked the online team to keep the cameras on. At exactly 10 a.m., the trail hit the road from Mukono with party leaders and members of parliament joined the convoy to Mukono district. The only blockage by police was in the heart of Mukono town, where Kyagulanyi was scheduled to open party offices. This sparked a verbal exchange between police and NUP leaders, but eventually the latter accepted and used another route to access Ntao. Despite police blockage, thousands of excited supporters lined up on the roadside to catch a glimpse of the former presidential candidate as others trailed his convoy on foot. At Nasuti, Kyagulanyi blamed security officials for blocking him, and yet they had a meeting with the force's top boss on Monday and agreed on a number of guidelines. Then came Friday. NUP supporters headed by Chairman Nyanzi staged a procession in Masaka awaiting Chagulanyi's arrival. However, they cried foul of the antagonistic gang, who allegedly pulled down NUP posters and even stoned their vehicles. Nonetheless, at a slow but sure pace, Kyagulanyi pressed on with his supporters to Masaka City, where he addressed a mammoth crowd in the much-anticipated mobilization rally. This week, we also saw the first batch of pilgrims arrive at the Anglican site in Namgongo 12 days before the Igenda Matters Day celebrations due on June 3rd. The situation at Namgongo gained momentum by close of day on Tuesday, since the hosting diocese of Nebbi and its Christians, who had trekked more than 400 kilometers, were expected to make a triumph entry. The pilgrims from Nebbi arrived in Kampala on Tuesday and spent the night at Naguru Catholic Church.
Today the shrine is opening the door to receive all the pilgrims, and the rector of the shrine will give the key of the shrine to Nebbi Catholic Diocese.
Uganda police alongside sister security forces also deployed heavily along access routes to avert incidents of thugs mugging or snatching pilgrims' items. By Tuesday, 45 suspected criminals, including those that were using stones to attack people, had been arrested with the help of covert officers and CCTV cameras. Luka Wesijire, the deputy Kampala Metropolitan Police spokesperson, said operations targeting suspected criminals will continue through the celebrations. This week also saw the United States of America slap sanctions of five current and former Ugandan officials in alleged corruption and gross human rights violations. The five officials designated include the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, former Minister of Karamoja Affairs, Mary Gretu Kitutu, former Minister of State for Karamoja Affairs, Agnes Nandutu, and Minister of State for Finance, Amos Lokolobi. All four officials abused their public positions for their personal benefit at the expense of Ugandans, the document stated. Additionally, Peter Eleru, the former deputy chief of Uganda People's Defense Forces, is designated due to what is said to be involvement in gross violations of human rights. Specifically, Peter Eleru is accused of involvement in commanding UPDF forces in extrajudicial killings that were committed by members of the UPDF. As a result of these actions, the designated Ugandan officials are generally ineligible for entry into the United States. The State Department is also taking steps to impose visa restrictions on multiple other Ugandan officials for undermining the democratic process and repressing members of marginalized or vulnerable populations in Uganda. These individuals are responsible for or complicit in the repression of Ugandan members of political opposition groups, civil society organizers, and vulnerable communities in Uganda.